In this lecture, we see the vibrations of one-dimensional diatomic lattice. For this, let's assume one-dimensional that is linear primitive lattice with basis consisting of two atoms with masses capital M and small m, where capital M is greater than small m. So this is our first condition. By using this condition, let me draw linear primitive cell using these two atoms. So let's one atom with mass small m is with green color, and other atom with mass capital M is with blue color. As we know, there is a periodic repetition of these atoms. So here blue atoms in blue color are having mass capital M, and atoms in green color are having mass small m. And as we discussed in the case of monoatomic lattice, these atoms are attached to each other with these massless springs. So this is massless spring, with spring constant beta, as we discussed in the case of monoatomic lattice. So now let's this atom is 2n, that is I am marking this atom as 2n, then this atom is 2n plus 1 and this one is 2n plus 2, and this one is 2n minus 1. And one important thing here is that the distance between two dissimilar atoms is a, and the distance between two similar atoms is equal to 2a, and this is very important when we will define the zone boundary of Brillouin zone. So with atomic vibrations, this atom is displaced to this position, and this atom is displaced to this point. And similarly, this atom is displaced to this position. And in a similar manner, this atom at 2n minus 1 position is displaced to this position. So we can write this as u2n and this distance as u2n plus 1 and similar to this. So this distance is u2n plus 2. Similarly, this distance is u2n minus 1. So now we have to write equation of motions for these vibrations for atom with blue color and green color with masses M and capital M. So first let's concentrate on this atom, and this atom is experiencing a force due to this atom and this atom. Similarly, this atom can be influenced by the force which is generated by this spring using this atom and this atom. So first let's write the force on atom which is located at 2n position, that is force on 2n atom which is equal to beta, and this is combination of the force exerted by this atom and this atom. So first let me write equation for this. So here extension in this spring is equal to u 2n plus 1 minus u2n plus beta, and extension is in this spring is equal to u2n minus 1 minus u2n. And as we did in the case of monoatomic lattice, here u2n minus 1 is smaller than u2n. So we can write, let me make it bigger. Here beta u2n plus 1 minus u2n minus beta u2n minus u2n minus 1. And we can write this as there are two u2n with minus sign. So we can, this is, so we can write it as u2n plus 1 plus u2n minus 1 minus 2 u2n. So this is the force on atom at position 2n. So I am writing it as equation number 1. In a similar way, we can write the equation for second atom, so which is located at a position 2n plus 1. This one at 2n plus 1. So here one force is equal to beta into the difference of these coordinates, which is 2n plus 2 minus 2n plus 1. So we can write this as F force on this atom is beta u 2n plus 2 minus u 2n plus 1 plus beta this force, so which is equal to u 2n minus u 2n plus 1. U 2n minus u 2n plus 1, and similarly we can write it as b u 2n plus 2 minus u 2n plus 1 minus beta u 2n plus 1 minus u 2n. So here we can see there are two u 2n plus 1 terms with negative sign, so we can write finally F 2n plus 1 which is equal to beta u 2n plus 2 plus u 2n minus 2 u 2n plus 1. So this is equation number second. So using these two equation for forces we can write equation of motion. So equations of motions for these two masses can be written as that is first one is m d square u 2n by dt square which is equal to F 2n and which is again equal to beta u 2n plus 1 u 2n plus 1 plus u 2n minus 1 minus 2 u 2n minus 2 u 2n. So let me consider this as equation number 3. In a similar way, we can write equation of motion for mass m which is equal to m d square u 2n plus 1 by dt square which is equal to F 2n plus 1 which is equal to beta u 2n plus 2 plus u 2n minus 2 u 2n plus 1. Let me write it as equation number 4. So as we did for the case of monoatomic lattice, now we have to consider periodic displacement, and after putting those values we can get solution of this equation number 3rd and 4th. So I am writing this solution directly as, so the solutions of equations 3 and 4 gives us omega square, which is equal to beta 1 by capital M, 1 by small m, plus minus beta under root 1 by plus capital M plus 1 by small m whole square minus 4 sine square k into the distance between two similar atoms, which is equal to 2a by 2 by small m and capital M. So we can cancel these two from here. So this is the solution for these two atoms with masses small m and capital M. And we know that the corresponding relation for monoatomic lattice is, we did it in the last class, which is equal to omega square 4 beta by m sine square ka by 2. So let's let me write this as equation number 5. And this is as equation number 6. And this solution we can get using coupled oscillation. Here two masses are having different, sorry, two atoms are having different masses. So we have to consider this formula. If these two masses are equal, then we have to write another formula. So here one thing is important to know, that here for every value of there are two L's of omega, one for atom with mass m and another for atom with mass capital M. So this is important to note. First one, so first we can notice that for monoatomic case there is only one value of omega for a single value of k. But in case of diatomic lattice, there are two values of omega for a single value of k, and these values of omega can be written as omega plus square, which is equal to, we can see from equation number, I think 6, sorry, from equation 5, we can see that here omega square is having two signs, one is plus, one is minus. So from using these two different signs, we can write first equation as omega plus square, which is equal to beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M plus beta under root 1 by small m 1 by capital M square minus 4 sine square Ka by M capital M. And second one is using minus sign between these two terms. So omega minus square, which is equal to beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M plus, sorry, minus beta under root 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M square minus 4 sine square Ka by M capital M. So now we are having these two equations. And it is important to note that here, I think it's equation number 7. So from here, we can note that omega plus branch is known as optical branch. So omega plus branch is known as optical branch, and omega minus branch is known as acoustic branch. So now we can consider different cases, that is when we, what is the nature of this omega versus k, when k tends to 0 and when k tends to its maximum value. And now we have to consider all both of these cases with optical branch and acoustic branch separately. So first, take case 1, that is for optical branch. So if we put k equal to 0, or if k tends to 0, then we know that sin k a is very small, so we can write sin k a as negligible. So by using this equation we can get omega plus, which is equal to, so if we put sin k a as 0, then we can get this as beta into this and plus this one. So we can simply write here as two beta into 1 by m plus 1 by capital M under root. So this is the value of optical branch when k tends to 0. At k tends to 0 or k is equal to 0. So this is first case. Then if sin k a tends to 1, that is maximum value of sin. In this equation we can simply see that here only variable function is sin k a, so we have to consider various values of this function only. So sin k a tends to 1, it means k a is equal to pi by 2. This means k is equal to pi over 2 a. So if we put k is equal to pi over 2 a, we can get sin k a equal to 1. So here we can write by putting this value on the omega plus square equation, we can get omega plus square, which is equal to beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M plus beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M square minus 4 m capital M. So on simplification we can write it as beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M plus beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M. So from here, sorry, this is minus. So from here we can cancel these values with capital M. So finally we are left with 2 beta by M. So here omega plus square is equal to 2 beta by M, and if we write for omega plus, then we can write omega plus which is equal to under root 2 beta by M. So this is the value of optical branch at k equal to pi over 2a. So now let's consider case 2. For acoustic wave or acoustic branch. So first, if k tends to 0, here important thing is that if we see this equation, if we put k, when k tends to 0, then if we put sin k a is equal to 0, then this term will be 0 and this term is equal to this term. So omega minus square will become as 0, so which is not possible. So here we can't neglect the minimum value of sin k a. So here we have to use another definition of sin theta. So we can write here sin ka which is equal to ka. We know that at small angle of theta, sin theta is equal to theta. So we are using that condition here. So here sin ka tends to ka. So by putting this value in that equation, we can get minus omega minus square which is equal to beta 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M minus beta under root 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M square minus 4 k square a square by m m m m plus m square. So Now we can write minus omega, which is equal to Ka 2 beta by m plus n under root. So this is the value of omega minus, that is optical branch at k tends to 0. So this is the case when k tends to 0. Now we have to consider if k tends to pi over 2a. So after putting this value, then omega minus or acoustic branch will become as 2 beta by m under root. So this is the value of acoustic branch at k tends to 0 or equal to, sorry, k tends to pi by 2a. So now we are with two values of omega plus and two values of omega minus. So now we can draw a graph between k and omega using these values. So first, let me draw the graph for acoustic branch. So on this scale it is k, and on this scale it is omega. And here important thing is to note the value of zone boundary. So here zone boundary is at minus pi over 2a and plus pi by 2a. So these are the zone boundaries. And here important thing is to note that when we take lattice constant as a, then the zone boundary is at pi over 2a. But here we are taking lattice constant or the distance between two similar atoms is 2a. So here we are taking zone boundary at pi over 2a. So first, let's draw a graph . So this is the graph for acoustic branch and this is the graph for optical branch. So this is optical branch. And at this point, This is under root 2 beta by capital M. And this point lies at a value which is equal to 2 beta by small m. And this is forbidden gap or energy gap or forbidden frequency band. Forbidden frequency gap. And here the maximum value is 2 beta 1 by m 1 by capital M under root. And as we know it, this is the zone boundary. And this is first Brillouin zone. So now let me write some important points using this graph. So first thing is vibrations split into two parts, one upper part or upper branch is known as optical branch and the lower branch is known as acoustic branch. Second point is note all the frequencies are allowed and there exists a forbidden band between optical and acoustic branch. Third point is width of forbidden band depends on the mass ratio of capital M by M. For the forbidden width increases with increase in capital M by small m and vice versa. The fourth point is if both masses are equal, then two branches meet at pi by 2a, that is plus minus pi by 2a, and forbidden band disappears. So from this graph, we can see that when small m and capital M are equal, then there is no forbidden gap between these two. And these two branches will meet at the zone boundary. So, and if this ratio increases, that is ratio of capital M by small m, then this forbidden gap will also be increased. So we can notice these points. Now we can note some key points regarding optical and acoustic branch. That is, what is optical branch? So in optical branch, the neighboring atoms move in opposite directions. And there amplitude are inversely proportional to their masses, so that the center of mass of the unit cell remains unchanged. So, as I draw the diagram as these atoms, let me draw this again. So there are two types of atoms. One type is with blue color and other one is with green color. So for optical branch, these blue atoms will move opposite to these green atoms. So we can make this diagram as it's like a wave. So green atoms are vibrating in this way. And blue atoms are vibrating or moving in a opposite way, that is these are blue atoms. All these atoms are maintaining a distance A and 2A. So in this way we can understand an optical branch. And here important thing is the vibrations of the optical branch can only be excited by a force which makes the two neighboring atoms move in opposite direction. Only optical radiations can induce this type of vibrations in crystals. Hence, these vibrations are called as optical vibrations or optical modes. And another important point is the existence of atoms with different charges or different masses is not an essential criteria to induce an optical vibrations. In a crystal. So here the important condition is, so first let me write another condition, that the mere presence of two atoms per primitive cell is the prerequisite for the generation of optical vibrations. For example, hexagonal closed packing, lattice having two atoms per primitive cell exhibit optical branches. So here the condition for producing optical branches is there must be two atoms per primitive unit cell, then only we can get optical branch in a crystal. For example, hexagonal closed packing and diamond like crystal structures have two atoms per primitive cell, so we can get optical branch for silicon, germanium, graphite. But metals like copper, gold, iron, these atoms only having one atom per primitive cell. So in these elements or atoms only acoustic branch is possible. So now let me write about acoustic branch. accounting branch. It's very easy to produce. So this is a view. So here both types of atoms are vibrating in same way. That is first, this is blue atom. So in a similar manner, green atoms are also with these atoms. So when atoms vibrate in this manner, then they produce acoustic branch or acoustic waves or acoustic vibrations. So this is acoustic branch. So in general, in acoustic branch, the neighboring atoms move in the same direction . This type of vibrations can be produced by directing a beam of sound wave on the surface of a crystal. Therefore, these vibrations are known as acoustic vibrations. So this is all about vibrations in diatomic lattice. So in next class, we will do some theory part. How can we visualize these monoatomic and diatomic lattice for doing our experiment? And in the next class, we will do the experiment in our laboratory.